I'm wearing an apron I made for my husband, believe it or not, for protection. He was doing stone sculpting, and he came home from the class every night covered in dust. So the other apron has old-fashioned pattern envelope models, and it says advanced patterns, and that was one of the first ones I tried. Back in the 50s, they had just holes in the pattern instead of any printing.
Hello. This is the story of this apron. This is a vintage apron. It's about 45 years old, and it reminds me that back when I lived in Canada, my parents had this really big house party, and it was like there was a valet guy there, and there was a coat rack, and all on the outside patio they had put up Chinese lanterns, and it was so cool, and they'd never done it again after that. And I always used to ask my mother, make a party with the Chinese lanterns again. So anyway, I found this in her house many moons ago and purloined it. And I don't wear it very often, but it really does look better with a tutu. It's so full that I just...
And my apron was made for me by my friend Lucia, who we've been friends since kindergarten. And I wear it at work when I sew at the pet shop. So it has dogs on it, and you all know I love dogs, so that's my
And actually, when I left home, I brought a Quilt for Valor apron. But when I went to Cracker Barrel for dinner, I found my turkey give thanks apron on sale for half price.
My apron was my mother's, who was a waitress in a lot of the hotels up in Upper State New York in the Catskill Mountains. She, of course, a lot of you know Dirty Dancing, but the hotels where we worked, I worked there at Grossinger's when I was in high school.
You did?
Yes, I did. And so I knew it meant a lot of celebrities and whatnot. But my mother was one of the last people to see Jane Mansfield before she passed, you know, got killed. So there's a lot of memories, and she did a lot of waitressing work and made a lot of
money. And my apron is also from my mother's. It's at least 60 years old. My mother made this with a Christmas tree on it, and it has large snap fasteners holding the Christmas tree so that the organdy can be washed, and she used it many, many times. It's been washed plenty, and I made one for myself, but I thought I'd show hers tonight.
My apron belonged to my mother-in-law, whom I never met. She had passed away before I got married, but I think it came from back in the 40s, and it looks very much, it's very utilitarian, and I think she probably made it herself.
Thank you, Ms. Marcia Degner. I married a car guy, and we bought our first Porsche in 1965, and we still ride them to this day. And the Porsche Club of America is probably the largest car club in the world with tons of members. Every year we have a Porsche parade. This is a memento from the down East region in 1986, and it brings back fond memories of, think of Houston on steroids. It's car events and rallies and a beauty show for the cars and great family camaraderie and all the lobster that I could possibly stuff into my face up in Maine.
I don't have a long story about this apron. It's fabric from Cape Facets and Philip Jacobson. I bought it in a quilt shop a few years ago because I just love the fabrics and I really love the design of it.
My name is Barbara Barron. It was hard for me to find an apron that didn't have a million spots on it. I love to cook. But I found this apron in my closet, Florida Culinary Institute. My husband and I have taken classes there, and it We just enjoyed it so much.
As you all know, that when I first got my embroidery machine, I told you I embroidered anything that was flat. So I ran out of things to embroider, and then I thought, oh, gee, my daughter, who doesn't cook, needs an apron. So I made her an apron for Christmas, and I embroidered all sorts of Christmas trees on it. And isn't that cute? And she does the obligatory Christmas dinner, so she does wear it at least once a year. And it really looks better on her than it does on me. She's slender, you know, and has no boobs. But I borrowed it from her just so I could show you all my apron.
I made them probably when I was between 8 and 10 years old. And it was an organization called Quanah Queens, and they were the women, the wives of the Quanah men. And anyway, they had these, I guess, workshops for students. And this was all made by hand, and I figured it was probably, the check was picked because I could follow the line. And also, these ties, and for a little girl, I'm thinking, oh, they're awfully long, but I have a feeling they probably didn't waste anything because this is like during the war or post-war. So even the salvage is still there. So this one I made by hand. And then
I found this apron in my garage after the last meeting. My mother-in-law's, it's from a bandana.
No, she needs to stand at the microphone, I can't hear you.
It's made from a bandana, two or three of them. It has a pocket. It was probably a cocktail apron because it really doesn't cover you. But with it came dish towels that you can hang up with buttons. So I have a whole set, so it doesn't exactly match. And the answer is it's on. A duster.
I am Ruth Burrills, model and spokesperson tonight. I am wearing my favorite of her three aprons. If you were a maid back in the day, you would wear your apron to work, do your chores and what have you, and before you would serve food, you would unbutton the front and have a clean apron to serve food underneath. Isn't that great? And according to Ruth, if you owned cottage roses, then you just had to have an apron made of cottage roses. This is an easy apron, according to Ruth. I've already tore the ribbon out more than once. But this is made with 1 yard of fabric and ribbon. And it's just run through the sides and what have you. So thank you, Ruth.
My 20th wedding anniversary with my husband. And I spent all my money at Liberty Fabric. So all I could buy for myself other than fabric, which I also found on the clearance rack, was this apron at Harrods that says, you can have your cake and eat it too at Harrods. And I ate plenty. And macarons.
These are my three aprons. They're all reversible. This one's my sister's Christmas present. And this one is mine. And this one will go to someone in the family.
Very nice.
They're only about a week old. Margaret Starr and I saw the idea for this apron. Someone was wearing it a couple months ago, and of course I stopped her and I grabbed her, and then at Mancuso, Laura of Laura's Sewing in Back was wearing one that someone had made her. So I got my hot little hands on it and I went, that's not hard. So I went to the friendly thrift store and for a buck, I bought a men's shirt. And that's all this is it's a man's shirt. I took the sleeves and I made pockets, but the pockets are really neat because they're double pockets. There's a pocket here and a pocket back here. Okay, so a nice deep pocket here and a not so deep pocket here, and since I'm never symmetrical, neither are they. Okay, and then there's a little pocket that went with it. And I think that the next time I will make sure I get a big, tall man, because then I don't have to put part of the sleeve on the bottom. Okay. So, and that's all it is, that and some binding.
When Rainey said about this program, I said, I know I have this apron that my mom, the
quilt procurer in our family had found it in a garage sale or whatever, you know, in her travels. And I said, where did I put it? I stuck it where I put the 30s and 40s vintage fabrics. So I did find it in Washington's Trace, but it's hand-pieced. And somebody must have just decided that it's not going to be a quilt top. It's going to be an apron.
I have a thing for coffee, coffee cups, coffee trivets, stuff all over the house that has to do with coffee. So I found this coffee fabric years ago. I bought it in two different colorways and made an apron.
My sister and I have a contest who can make which gift better. So my sister, who got me into quilting anyway,
made me this lovely apron that's reversible with potholders that match it. And now I have to figure out what to make for her.
Nice glass, yeah. And I'd like to tell you first about an apron that I don't have, and then I'll tell you about the one that I do have. The one that I don't have is my very first sewing project that I did when I was about 10 in 4-H, and I'm thinking about Rainey's story. And I'm also thinking about Jane Dent's, because mine was also gingham. We made an apron and we made pot holders, and I do still have the pot holders for some reason. They came with me, but the gingham was really neat because it did have nice straight lines you could follow. So it was perfect for a beginner. So I had a good experience with my first apron. Wow. This apron I did not make. Some of you know that I go to Paducah each year and I meet a group of friends that we have a guild together, a guild together. There's about 30 of us, and every year we exchange gifts. And we always have a theme each year. Well, a couple of years ago, the theme was to make an apron, and we exchanged by picking numbers and just picking a number out of a basket, and this was the apron that I received in the exchange.
I, too, have one of my mom's aprons. If I remember correctly, it comes from around the late 50s or early 60s, and it looks like this was not my sewing machine, must have been hers, but it has the stitches, fancy stitches that first came out that you could do on your sewing machine. So that's probably why she had done this one, to decorate it that way. It looks like a rickrack, but it isn't. It's just the thread on the sewing. And I'm like Rainey, when I cook, I get things on me. So I needed a top, because I, instead of going down here, I get everything on here. So I used one of her old hankies, and it's got a tatting edge. So I just sewed it on there and put a ribbon on it, and that's how I
I never wear apron. I don't particularly like apron. But a good friend of mine went on a cruise and she stopped in Russia, and she found this, and for some reason she was very, very attracted to it, and she said she bought it because the doll here looked like me. So I don't know if it's a compliment or not.
I cook like I paint. I've worn this two nights this week already. The dogs and cats always are hovering around me when I'm cooking. I participated in an internet machine embroidery swap and received this apron. I would have never done anything this difficult. I was really the lucky recipient. But I have a funny story to tell. One night I had been cooking and I forgot to take my apron off, and then I started painting, and I have an apron for painting too, so that I don't ruin all my clothes. At about 10 o'clock, I looked at myself and I had on two aprons.
I want to show you that was Ellen's, that was given to her when you were a little person.
Oh, I was about 14 and something.
It came from France in the 40s. I had a pen pal in France when I was a teenager, about 13 or 14. And we corresponded for several years during our junior high and high school years. And she sent me this. It's made out of silk. It had a ribbon on it, but
the ribbon is kind of rotted away. There's not much of it left, and it's one of those that you just kind of pin on to whatever it is you're wearing. But I never had the nerve to wear it. In the first place, I'd rather mess up my clothes than wear an apron anyway. Because aprons always have ruffles and you have to iron them, and my clothes don't. So, but this is just a treasure that I've always kept.